You talked me into it. It's late now, James. Just do it if you want it. It's late. It's already going. Just put the stop where I said. 106.10. Let's just not even look at it. Maybe we'll get lucky and it'll drop at $2 right now. Anyways, the point I was trying to make was this guy is in love with this girl. And he loves her and she doesn't love him. It's not that she hates him. It's that she doesn't know him that well. And she is not going to just fall in love with him the second that she meets him or they go out on a date. So he is paying a lot of attention to her and giving her a lot of affection and buying her flowers and sending her texts and calling. And he wants her to fall in love with him. So it takes time, it takes energy, it takes all that stuff, okay? This here is the market. This is money. And this is your trading account or bank account, whatever you want to call it, okay? So when you are trading, in order to get the money into your account, you have to give this a lot of time and a lot of energy. It's very much like love. It's like you give and you give and you give the time and energy, wanting the outcome, which is the money going into your bank account or your trading account. You want it there. You want it there the second. Every time you take a trade, you want the money. We lost in Red Hat today. We'll see how this turns up here now. If Clack's going to do what Starbucks did yesterday, I don't know. But you have to give it time and energy and effort, just like this guy has to give the girl the love. And if you don't, then the likelihood of you having the money over here or the girl in love with you is very, very low. Put it that way. Low odds that would happen. Does that make sense? Here, let me check this real quick. Well, this is still okay if you want to do it. Went down to 33. I don't think it goes over 106. Anyways, the point I was trying to make here is that you have to give trading time and energy and effort and love. And I think one of the reasons, and again, I've been teaching people for 6 years, but doing it for a long time, is that people don't give it enough. In the period of the time that I was teaching myself how to trade, I really did give 150% to it. I gave it every day, 7 days a week, studying on weekends. I gave it my all. I gave it everything I had. I couldn't have given any more. And I figured out a great system. So some people cannot give everything they got because they have families or whatever, but I know that people don't give even 50% of what they could give. And then they question and wonder why they aren't successful. And very often people want to give less than nothing. Very often people want to come, and I'm doing an open house this week and people are here and they're welcome to come. But very often people just want to go from open house to open house, of free trial to free trial. And they think that they're going to learn how to trade or get the money over here or get the girl to love them, and they're not. So your ability to be able to be successful is tied directly with how much energy and effort and time and money you want to give something, and in a condensed period as well, because if you are giving it your all 100%, even in a squished period of time, that also helps too, rather than mapping it out. Now, if it's not possible, if you can't give 100% because of other responsibilities in a short period of time, then you take the time you can give it. But very often people give so little, and they think that they're giving a lot, but they're really not. They're giving very, very little comparatively. I mean, you give until you fall over and you're exhausted. That kind of energy and effort. Qualibri, I lost what you meant there by that. I don't understand what you meant. Brad's saying he knew it, he needs money to get the girl. James, 47 for the clack, which you probably could get a better price on this now. Here, let's look. It's backed up. Well, it's, you could get a better price on it now. It looks good though. This is probably going to take a couple hours though as well, but Starbucks was worth it. Getting back to what I was saying. No, I had this up, Mimi. I had this slide up. Anyways, it's very much like relationships. You're having a relationship, but the relationship is with the market and the relationship is also with yourself. When you want to trade, you want to be successful, the amount of time and energy you put into it is up to you. If you're not that serious about it, then I don't know why you should be successful. I'm such a, what's the word? My personality is so extreme that I will not be bothered doing something unless I really want to be successful doing it. So I don't half-ass anything. So that's my personality. And I'm not saying anybody has to be like me, but I'm saying you don't do any benefit to yourself by half-assing it trading. You really just lose money over a long period of time. And that's just dumb to me. But it, you know, there's most people, that's what they do. Shower Singer, email me and I'll send you that guy. Because it's a different place now. There are plenty of people who won't give much, but also those who give less than nothing. And they will think that you automatically owe them if they deign to give you a smidgen. Are you talking about relationships? I don't know what you're talking about now, Koala Bear. You've completely lost me now. Are you talking about relationships? Are you talking about love? Are you talking about the market? It's like a clack. Okay, clack, I still think holds 106. So if you're in clack, if you didn't, 106.10 is the stop. If you didn't do it, then you didn't do it. And you just stopped today with a loss in Red Hat. I think this could hold too, just like Starbucks, but go all day. Target's 103. Green Mavericks and Clack, okay. One of the difficulties is that people don't realize how much you can't control. Like, he can't control this girl falling in love with him. Like, obviously, he wants her to fall in love with him immediately, today. Just like everybody wants the money from the market immediately, right now, today, this second. Everyone wants it immediately. Sometimes it doesn't work out that way, but it doesn't mean you're not going to get it. But if you don't give it everything you've got, you're never going to get it. So if he doesn't keep calling this girl and asking her out and bringing her flowers, she's never going to fall in love with him. And she could care less. I mean, she'll just go on and date somebody else. Just like the market will go on and, you know, give money to other people, take money from other people. It doesn't care. It does not, the market does not care if you trade or not. If you don't ever, ever trade again, the market could care less. Billions of other people will come in and trade after you. It doesn't care. It's cold. It's a cold way of thinking, but it's really the same as the way relationships are with people, because you can't make someone love you. He can't make her love him, and she might never, but he's got to give it his all. And the fact that he loves her, he does. So if you really, really love the concept, the idea of being successful as a trader, the lifestyle, if you really love looking at charts, if you love the thrill and the excitement and the highs of making money in the market in a few minutes, if you love the idea of working from home, if you love all the things about trading that make you want to do it in the first place, if you love all of that, the independence, then you will keep going and you will give it your all till you get to the point that you need to get to where you're successful. But if you quit, the market won't care. And if you half-ass it, you'll never make it. And if he half-asses it with her, some other guy will come in and do everything right. And then it'll be too late. That's like a clack. And that often happens. Clack is holding. It pushed back against me now here, but it's holding. But that's why I said put the stop at 106.10. Still looks okay. Anyways, I think everybody gets my point. Listen, if you're in this, I'm here. I'm in it. I'm going to close the room, but I'm here. I know some of you emailed me yesterday about Starbucks. I'll be here if you have questions. First target's 105 when clack, if you're in it. I don't think that many people are in it. The dream target would be 103. I do believe we need the market for that. Here, I'll go over this clack for Mimi. Hold on.